So, eggs are pretty tasty, right? Sometimes they just make me so angry, I want to smash them. So this episode is going to be a little bit different than our typical episode. Since today, August 8th, is my birthday, I just want to kind of have some fun instead of, you know, science stuff. This is just messing around. So this video is all about destroying eggs in various ways. And just like the intro clip there, we're just going to just drop it and watch it smash. Or I guess I'll throw it down. Very nice. All right, so next I'm going to karate chop an egg, and I'm just gonna gather my inner chi. You ready? No. Ah! Trigger. Did it? Next up is the golf swing. I'm terrible at golf, but I'll give it a go. All right?
Yep.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Try to keep it as... Whoa! That wasn't it, I promise. Don't slow-mo that. Okay. Now you ready?
Yep.
Trigger! Oh my gosh!
Ugh.
Right in my nose.
Oh, I'm sorry. I got like on my legs.
Oh, look at my pants. Oh man.
Not all right. Good.
That's gotta look sweet in slow motion though. All right, and what are we gonna do to the egg now?
Shooting with BB.
Shooting it with one BB?
No, I think multiple.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch in there. And we pumped that, what, 10, 12 times?
Yeah, about.
And we've got our egg sitting on a little tee right there. It's gonna go away. All right. And... trigger. Ooh, that was beautiful. How did that happen? There's not even a hole there. It's just the shell is gone. How does that happen? That's weird. All right, so now we've got an egg with a little hole in the top, and we're gonna put a firecracker in it and blow it up. Grace, what is your job right now?
I have to hold this window pane over the high-speed camera lens.
To protect our precious high-speed camera.
Yep.
Oh my gosh.
Well, good thing we had that there.
Yeah. Okay, so this was ground zero for the explosion. And if we go all the way over here, This is how far a shrapnel went. That's pretty crazy. What'd you think?
So exciting. Got everywhere.
So thanks for watching us destroy some eggs, and we're gonna head inside and look at our footage. Yeah.
Okay, and as we said earlier, today is actually Bryce's birthday, and we decided
How old am I?
You're 19.
19.
And we decided to do an episode where we just have fun and smash stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Eggs.
And, yes, eggs. I'm not really sure what sparked the idea for this other than eggs are funny to explode and smash and stuff. They're typical slow motion stuff, and so... You know, the first thing we did was just as if you were to drop an egg when you're in the kitchen, when you're outside, whatever. And this is a little bit different from the rest of our videos because usually we do like 2,500 frames per second and then we'll do it super slow at 10,000 frames per second. But that means we can only do about three different things before the episode gets too long. And so for this, we did quite a bit more things, but we only did 5,000 frames per second for each one. And so... There's an egg splatting at 5,000 frames per second. And I'm pretty sure you've seen this before on HighSpeedFanatics. I mean, we've what, blended eggs? I think once at the end of an episode we did drop an egg on something. We've shot an egg.
Weed whacked an egg.
Eggs are just pretty well-rounded, hated upon in the HighSpeedFanatics community. And, of course, you see what you'd expect. The bottom of the egg that's contacting the table, since that needs to get out of the way the quickest, it turns into really small pieces. And then we get two main chunks here, and then as it, you know, splits apart, it breaks all the way in half, and then the egg yolk sort of opens up. Nothing too extraordinary. Egg-stroordinary. So yeah, you saw me karate chop the egg here, and when I first watched this back, I couldn't help but notice that the angle that this is from, because I was like, in relation to the camera, I wasn't going like this, I was going like that, and just from the focal length and everything, it makes my hand look really short and stubby. I promise my hands are not like that. But yeah, 5,000 frames per second again, karate chop an egg. This episode isn't going to be very scientific because that's not really the intent here. But what I found interesting is if we look right at my pinky finger when I first contact the egg, you actually see a little ripple go through my finger. Like, it actually pushed against my finger quite a bit. And I didn't expect that from the egg because, you know, you think of it as really brittle and not very hard. But it actually pushed against my finger first, and then, you know, I split it apart. And then you see my fingers contort from hitting the table and everything. And the third thing we did, which was putting a golf tee in the ground and then putting an egg on top of that, hitting it with a golf club. And this is a... What type of club is that? Is that an iron? Is that what that's called? That shape is an iron?
I guess.
Whatever.
I have no idea. I don't play.
I was going to use a driver, but I figured that was overkill. So I just used an... I think that's called an iron. Maybe that's a... I don't know anything about golf.
It looks like a putter.
But irons are typically, you know, like slanted up, so when you hit it, it pushes it up. Which, actually, since this is designed to, you know, push the golf ball up, that's kind of what we see here because, you know, it compresses the egg, and then it, you know, it shoots it all up like that. And that's what got my pants full of eggs. But, I mean, all of these shots are going to have some sort of science principle in them. For instance, this one right here, we have a piece of metal traveling at a certain velocity, and this entire surface is flat. And so when that contacts a spherical object, well, oblong spherical object, they contact basically at a very small point. this means an incredible amount of pressure because it's only a very small amount of surface area that this force is being applied on. And so immediately, there's a lot of pressure right here. And that translates into the fluid inside of the egg to begin pushing outwards against the egg. So even though we're only contacting here, we're going to get cracks propagating out here too because it's forcing the liquid out too. And then, you know, sort of like evenly distributes out. And then we get like this wave of yolk and eggshells.
In this clip, we actually shot it with a BB gun, and we had multiple BBs in the barrel, so it'd all shoot out at the same time and pretty much mutilate this thing.
I actually expected... Oh, there we go. Since all of these... it was a multiple pump BB gun, and of course I loaded in one, I pumped it like 10 or 12 times, and then I, you know, put like 10 more in, 10 more BBs, and I expected them to all shoot out in a line, because I expect like these line of BBs to come and just tear through this this egg. But as you see, that was obviously the last BB that I put in, and then the rest come out like a shotgun. And I don't really know how that happened. But well, actually this is, you know, a lot more cool because you know, there's BBs hitting like at a lot of different points on this egg. If you remember, after I shot it, I looked at the eggshell and there were parts of it that looked like it had been broken through, but only the shell had come off and there was still a little like membrane in there. You saw that?
Mm-hmm.
But you look right here and these BBs are like tearing through like the egg. And so those holes is what we were looking at earlier. I don't get it. Like, what? I'm not sure what happened, because there was still that thin membrane underneath where the shell had been, but these are obviously tearing through it. So I don't know what happened there.
Mystery.
But yeah, basically, since there's a lot of BBs, we have a lot more surface area total pushing against the shell. And since it's easy for these to go through liquid, more easy than it is to go through a solid, these are all contacting the shell and dragging along with the shell. And so that's why this gets pulled away from the oak tree. No, this gets pulled away from the yolk, and then the yolk just sort of like stays there for a bit before it, you know, pulls apart and falls. So that was pretty interesting. And again, this is at, you know, 5,000 frames per second.
Okay, so this clip was actually my favorite, because I just like that we used firecrackers.
Yep.
This is a
return of the fireworks. Yeah, it was kind of hard to do, but at the top, I took a knife and just sort of like very lightly chiseled away at the shell to make a little hole, and then I sort of like poked on the edges and that like, you know, tore it apart slowly, just enough for me to fit a firecracker in there. And then I just lit it and blew it up. I mean, you could tell that the yolk, I mean, when we put the firecracker in, it must have pushed the yolk over this way, because when it exploded, all the yolk was, you know, going this way, and then everything else exploded outwards. What's cool is we got one frame. This looks like a star. Actually, a star going supernova. And then obviously there was a weak point, or the yolk made more pressure on that side. I don't know, but that's where it exploded out first. Since all of the pressure built up from the explosion is coming out this way, it sort of like forces it to open up. And then sort of, you know, moves backwards, and that's what we see right here. But yeah, so I mean, not really a scientific episode very much, so there's not like a ton of analysis to do on these shots, and I apologize for my voice, but I've been sick for like 3 days, and I don't feel too well, but this made me happy. So thanks for watching episode 21, I think it was?
Yes.
Yeah. And, you know, sometimes we do episodes where we just have fun, so if you have an idea that, you know, may not be scientific, but just fun, you know, just shoot us an email or comment or whatever you want, and we'll probably do it. So thanks for watching episode 21, and we'll see you next week. Thanks for watching this week's episode of High Speed Fanatics. You can follow us on Twitter at username HighSpeedFans.
You can also find us at facebook.com/HighSpeedFanatics.
If you have any questions or suggestions, please feel free to send us an email at HighSpeedFanatics@gmail.com.